Hello students, in this video lecture we will study the basic of set theory. Most of you might be already aware about this topic, but some of those who have not studied yet may recall this in this video lecture. So in this video lecture we are going to study what is set, how to represent a set, and then we will study types of set, how many types are there, and we will perform some operations on set. And at last, we will try to discuss some questions on problems of set. So here we start. First is, what is set? I will try to discuss this topic with an example. Let's say we have some kind of fruits. Let's say apple, mango, banana, and so on. So many fruits are there. So we can consider it in a class, that is fruit. Means we can group the objects into a single one and we can recall it fruit. So fruit will be a set. So what the definition says, the set is a well-defined collection of definite object of perception or thought. George Cantor was said to be the father of set theory. George Cantor was a mathematician. He was called the father of set theory. A set may also be thought as grouping together of single objects into a whole. As I gave you example of fruit, in fruit class, you can consider so many fruits like apple, mango, banana, and so on. If you group them into a single object, then it will be called a set. So what the definition says, a set is a well-defined as an unordered collection of distinct elements of the same type, where type is defined by the writer of the set. Means who is writing the set, he will be able to describe what kind of set he has built. For example, we are seeing in this that there are two examples, set A and set B. In set A, what is there? A, B, C, D, and E. First five letters of alphabetically series. And then in set B, January, February, March, April, and May. First 5 months. How to represent a set? Mainly, there are two approaches to represent a set. First is set builder form, and second is roster form. So what is the difference between set builder and roster form? In set builder form, we denote the set using an alphabetically series, means using a notation. But in roster form, what we do in roster form, we try to contain all the elements in using some comma, separated elements separated by the comma. So if you take about first example, if you talk about first example, it says the set of all vowels in English alphabet. So if you talk about set builder form, how we will represent this sentence? This is a sentence like there are English vowels of English alphabet. So set builder form says X, such that X is a vowel. What this colon represent? This is such that symbol. X, such that X is a vowel in the English alphabet. And how many vowels are there? A, E, I, O, U. So roster form will consider those elements that are included in A, E, I, O, U. It has been included in roster form. So basically difference is that in set builder form, we use some rule. We define the set using some rule. But in roster form, we represent set of elements separated by comma. In the second example, the set of all odd positive integers less than or equal to 15. So set builder form will be represented at X, such that X is an odd number. We have specified X is an odd number as it is given in the sentence. And because odd numbers are infinite, so we will have to consider only integers that are less than or equal to 15. So what condition we will give? X greater than 0 and less than or equal to 15. So we will have to specify this. If we don't specify this, then X will consider infinite amount of odd numbers. And in roster form, we have tried to cover 1 to 15 odd numbers. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, and 15. Similarly, again example, all set of all positive cube number less than 100. So how we will write in set builder form? X such that X is a cube. And what is the condition? X is greater than 0 and less than 100. And how many numbers will be included in 8? Then 2 cube, then 3 cube, and then 4 cube. If we talk about 5 cube, it will be 125. So we have to consider less than only 100. So 125 will not be considered in the roster form. Again, we can recall this in set builder form, set is represented by using statements depicting relation among its element. And in roster form, set is represented by listing all elements in braces, as I've already told you. You can see an example too. In roster form, we have represented set by using elements separated by commas. And in set builder form, we have represented using some statement. Now we discuss about various types of set. There are various types of set, but we will discuss this in detail. First is empty set, singleton set, finite set, infinite set, equal set, equivalent set, universal set, subset, proper subset, super subset, and proper super subset and power set. Now we will see it in detail. First of all, a singleton set. What is a singleton set? The set in which there is only one element. Like we can see here, like in this set, only one is included. In this set, only zero is included, means only one member or one element is there. So these are all singleton sets. Next, finite set. Such type of set in which we can count the elements in the set. Those will be called finite set. A set consisting of natural numbers or natural number of object. It means in which number element is infinite, is said to be a finite set. For example, A and B. In A and B, we can count the elements. We can tell how many elements are there. So it is a finite set. But if we talk about infinite set, in infinite set, we cannot count the elements. Means there are infinite amount of elements. For example, the set of all natural numbers is given by n equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on, and so on. Infinite, because natural numbers are infinite, so it is an infinite set. What is equal set? Two set which have exactly the same numbers as in A, means two set A and B consisting of same element. For example, I have considered one set, let's say fruit A, and second set of fruit B. If A have mango, banana, and orange, and similarly B have also mango, banana, and orange, then because the elements of the set, both set are equal, so it will be called equal set. What is null set? A set with no member. It means a set with no element will be called empty set. It will be denoted by the curly braces, or we can use a symbol, that is phi. So two popular representation of empty set are there, either use curly braces or a special symbol called phi. Next is subset. A subset A is said to be the subset of B if every element which belongs to A also belongs to B. For example, we can see in A it is 1, 2, 3 there, and in B it is 1, 2, 3, 4 there. So all the elements of A are included in B. So A is the subset of B. Next, we talk about proper set. A set is said to be proper subset of B if A is subset of B, A is not equal to B. Means A is subset of B, but both are not equal. Then it will be called a proper set. Improper set. A set A is called an improper subset of B if and only if A equal to B. If A is a subset, but A equal to B, both sets are equal, then it will be called a improper subset. Then we talk about power set. Power set is a set defined as a set of every possible subset. If the cardinality of A is N, then the cardinality of power set is cookie power N. We can see here what is power set. Let's say I have a set A. And it included three members in it, one element, two, and three. And someone asked me to calculate its power set. So there will be eight elements in it, because in A there are three elements. So in power set there will be two to the power three elements. It means eight elements will be there in power subset. So one element will be your 5 and second element will be your 1 and second next element will be your 2 and then you can include 3 and then we will try to merge the two elements means 1, 2 and then we will try to take 2, 3 next element we can take 3, 1 and next element we can take in power set 1, 2, 3 means the set A as a whole. So one element will also be there. I am writing an empty set. It is an empty set. It will also be there. So there are 8 elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This will be called the power set of the set A. Hope you are clear with this concept. Next, we talk about universal set. What is universal set? For example, we have set A and set C. Then we take, if we are taking S, S includes 0 to 9 elements. So A is also included in S and C is also included in S. So we can say S is universal set for A and C. Hope you are clear with this concept. Now, any set which is a superset of all the set under consideration is said to be universal set, either denoted by omega or S or U. Now we will discuss operations on set. There are basically 5 operations. First is union, second intersection, complement, Cartesian product, and symmetric difference. We will see it in detail. How can we calculate union of set? Union of two set is the smallest set which contain all the elements of both the set. Means, but we can include the element of both the sets but without repeating any element. For example, let's say A is a set that has included 2, 4, 5, 6 as an element and set B has 4, 6, 7, 8. It has 4 elements. So we have to calculate the union of A and B. Because 4 is in common in both and 6 is common in both. So while taking union, we will avoid repeating 4 and 6. So what we will write? 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the union of these two sets. And it is denoted by a capital U symbol. Next, definition of intersection of set. Intersection of two set is the largest set which contains all the elements that are common to the both the set. In intersection, what we do, we take the common elements that are included in both the set and that will be our answer. The common elements will be our answer. The symbol of denoting intersection is this one. Let's say A is this and B is this. So we will try to find out common elements in this. 3 and 5. 3 and 5 are common elements. Intersection will be 3 and 5. It is denoted by A intersection B and how we can write it? X. Such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. If we symbolically write this statement, it will be written as A intersection B equal to X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. Means X is such element which belongs to both the set. Next, how to find the difference of two set? To calculate the difference of two set, what we try to cover. Suppose we have to calculate A minus B, the difference of two set A minus B. A minus B will denote the elements of A which are not the element of B. Means we have to cover those elements that are included in A but not included in B. For example, if set A is 2, 3, 4 and B is 4, 5, 6. So what will be A minus B? 2 is included in A but 2 is not in B. Similarly, 3 is included in A, but 3 is not in B. So 2 and 3 will be our answer. If we consider 4, So 4 in A and B both. So we will not take this 4. So A minus B will be 2, 3. Hope you are clear with this. I have given some example. Try to solve that, this example. Next, how to find Cartesian product of two set? Cartesian product is the combination of two set. And how we write it? Cartesian product A cross B. We denote it using A cross B. A is one set and B is another set. Then A cross B will be, it will represent the elements in some ordered pair. And what is ordered pair? In due to ordered pair, how we denote ordered pair? We write a braces, then X and comma Y, and then bracket close. Then we say it an ordered pair. So A cross B will be X comma Y, such that X belongs to A, means the first element of ordered pair will belong to set first set, and second element of ordered pair will belong to second set. So X comma belongs to A, and Y belongs to B. This is the representation of partition product of set. For example, if we talk about this example, if A equal to 7, 8 and B equal to 2, 4, 6, then we have to find A cross B. So A cross B will be written as 7, 2. We will combine, we will take first element of A and first element of B. So it will make an ordered pair 7, 2. If we take first and second of B, then it will make 7, 4 order pairs. So 7, 4 is written as, then 7, 6, and then 8, 2, 8, 4, and 8, 6. We will combine all these sets with all the other set, the element of all other set. Thus, we can find Cartesian product. And the last operation is symmetric difference of two set. Symmetric difference is calculated using some formula, and the formula is, we denote it by a del, symbol del. Del is read as X symmetric difference Y. Its formula is X minus Y union Y minus X. For example, A is 1, 2, 3, 5, 6 and B is 0, 5, 6, 7. Then we have to find A del B. And A del B represent X A symmetric difference B. So A minus, first of all, we will have to calculate A minus B and B minus A, and then we will have to take the union of A minus B and B minus A. So A minus B is, we have calculated, and it is 1, 3. B minus A is 0, 7. And what we have did, we have took union of this. So A 1, 3 union 0, 7. So symmetric difference is 1, 3, 0, 7 is your answer. Next question. In next question, we have to calculate A union B, A union C, B union C, B union D, and so on. Many more options are there. So what is the question? A equal to 2, 3, 4, 5. B equal to this one. C is this set and D is this set. Then we have to find A union B. We will merge all the elements of A and B without repetition. So A union B will be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A union C, similarly, we will merge the set element of set A with the element of set C without repetition. If we see the last one, we have to calculate A union D first, then we have to take intersection of B union C. So A union D, we will merge the element of set A with the element of set D. So A union D will be this one, intersection B union C. B is this one and C is this one. We will calculate union of these both. This is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So intersection will include all the common element between these two sets. So 4, 5, 8, 9 are common. So we have written 4, 5, 8, 9 as our answer. In the last is third question. If P equal to A, B, C, D and Q equal to B, D, F and R equal to A, C, E, verify that. We have to verify these two statements, whether these are true or false. So if we talk about for proving first small a part, in a small a part, LHS says P union Q, and then we have to find union of R. P union Q, what P union Q denote? What will P union Q denote? In P union Q, we will try to cover all elements of P and Q. So it will be written as A, B, C, D, F. a a b c d and f. And now in LHS we have to take its union with what? With R. R is A C E. So what will be its answer? It will include, because C is repeated both the times, A is repeated both the time, we will not repeat it any union. We will write it as A B C D E and F. This will be its union. But if we talk about its RHS, RHS. First of all, RHS says take union of Q and R, and then we will get the answer of Q union R, then we will combine it with P. So what Q union R is? B, D, F, A, C, E. So we will write A, B, C, D, E and F. This is our Q union R, and in right hand side we will combine it with P. So we will when we take its union with P, P is A, B, C and D. So it will, what will be the answer? It will calculate as, it will be calculated as, we will not repeat this element. We will write one element once, A, B, C, D, E, and F. So here we can see that LHS is equal to RHS, right hand side. It means first statement is true. And it should have true because it is an association rule. It is an associative rule. So it is true. Similarly, we can check for the second statement. It is the association rule for intersection. So it will always be true. So thank you, class. You can practice on more and more questions. You can practice more questions related to set theory. And these were the basic topics related to set theory. So thank you, class.